Hi everyone, this is Riley at inMusic, and in this video, you'll learn all about gain staging and how to use proper gain staging techniques in your recording setup with your M-Audio audio interface. So, first and foremost, what exactly is gain staging? Put simply, gain staging is the process of ensuring that all your volume and gain settings in your signal chain are adjusted properly. The idea is to balance the gain of your incoming sound at each stage of the signal, making sure none of them are causing clipping by being set too high. Before we get to some examples, it's important to make sure you have the correct input type selected on the channel you're using. These settings vary depending on which devices you want to plug in and record. For instruments with passive pickups, connect it with a 1/4-inch instrument cable and set the input type to instrument. For line-level devices, like mixers, keyboards, and guitars and basses with active pickups, also connect it with a 1/4-inch cable and set the switch to line. If you're using stereo inputs, make sure both channel input switches are set to the same setting. For microphones, connect it with an XLR cable and set the input switch to line. We recommend only connecting microphones to the XLR input. If you're using a condenser microphone, make sure to turn the phantom power switch on. Enabling phantom power will send out 48 volts of electricity to the microphone to give it power, which is required for all condenser mics. When phantom power is enabled, it'll be sent to both of the XLR channels on interfaces with more than one input. So if you have two microphones connected, make sure that neither of them will be negatively affected by phantom power. Phantom power is mostly harmless, but it could be detrimental to some ribbon microphones. If you're unsure if your mic requires phantom power, check with your microphone's manufacturer to be sure. So, let's check out a basic example of gain staging. In this setup, I have an electric guitar with passive pickups plugged directly into input 1 on my interface. Here, there are two gain stages, the guitar's volume knob and the interface's input gain. So I'm going to start playing something to test the input, and we can see the signal clip light is green, which is good, but there's noise audible in the signal. This means I need to send a louder signal into the interface. The only other gain stage I have here is the guitar's volume knob, and if I check that, I have some room to turn it up. So I'll do that, and recheck my interface input. Since it was set high before, the signal is now clipping, so I'll just turn that down until the signal clip light is green again. Sounds good. Always refrain from cranking up the input gain on the interface to compensate for a low signal, since it can introduce noise and hiss, especially when you start approaching 10. Here's another setup that's a bit more complicated. Here, I have a DJ media player plugged into a mixer, and the stereo line outputs from the mixer plugged into inputs 1 and 2 on the interface. So here, we have 5 stages of gain. On the mixer, the channel gain, channel volume, and main output, and on the interface, the 2 input gains. If I'm hearing noise or distortion in the signal, or I see a clipping indicator on the interface or one of my devices, I simply check each gain stage's level by testing its volume or gain control and listening for a reduction in the unwanted noise. After checking each stage, we find out that the mixer channel's gain is set too high, so I'll just turn that down until I hear the noise disappear and I don't see clipping anywhere on my meters. Then I readjust the gain stages that follow it, which in this case are the mixer's main output and the 2 interface input gains. So there are a few examples of hardware gain staging in action. But don't forget this concept also applies to the tracks and effects you're using in your DAW. Just like your hardware devices, plugins often have built-in volume and gain controls as well, and you need to pay attention to them to keep your signal sounding its best. For example, here's a basic project I'm working on in MPC Beats right now. So I'm going to go to the mixer and solo out this bassline track. So on this track, I'm using 3 plugins, an equalizer, distortion, and a compressor. If I click on the EQ, we can see it has its own output control, and so do the distortion and compressor plugins. All 3 of these output controls are gain stages in this track, and they feed into each other in whatever order I have them arranged. If any of them are set too high, the track might start clipping. So you'll see, if the compressor's output is turned up really high, the track output starts clipping. We can see there on the VU meter. turning it down to a more reasonable level returns the signal to its original quality. Now, this compressor is the last gain stage in this effects chain, meaning the distortion plugin is feeding its output directly into the compressor, while the EQ is feeding directly into the distortion. Always make a habit of checking each gain stage in a signal when troubleshooting in your DAW. Just because a track isn't clipping doesn't necessarily mean it's not the cause of unwanted sound. For instance, if I have the EQ's output set really high, it feeds a clipping signal into the distortion plugin, which will then be sent into every gain stage that follows it. I do want this bassline to sound distorted, but not that distorted. So if I bring the EQ output down a bit, we can hear that unwanted distortion go away. If you've checked every gain stage in your project, and you're still hearing noise or otherwise impeding sound, then the problem is stemming from elsewhere. I've made two other videos for M-Audio interfaces. One on troubleshooting distortion, clicks and pops, and noise, and one for fixing audio playback and output issues. Take a look at both of those if you're still having audio trouble after gain staging. The links are down in the description. You'll find more M-Audio interface resources and the link for technical support there as well. Thanks so much for watching, I appreciate you tuning in, and happy recording!